الحمد لله وأحمده وأستعين به وأستغفره وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ونبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم تسليما. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah سبحانه وتعالى has made the purpose for us on this earth and many places of the Book of Allah. Why are we here? One of those verses is the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَابْتَغِي فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ, meaning seek with all the good things Allah has given you, whether it is health, age, whether it is the wealth, the children, and everything else. Seek with all that الدار الآخرة, الدار الآخرة, the hereafter. And therefore this should be the main goal for every Muslim. And this is also mentioned clearly in the saying of Allah, وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون, that I have not created both the jinn and the humans except for worshipping me alone. يعبدون. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. So life should have a share. You sleep, you eat halal food, you drink what is halal, and you enjoy what is halal. This is the verse. وَابْتَغِي فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ وَالدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ. That's your main goal. That's your main goal. Remember now, millions of Muslims mix up priorities. This is not their goal. Or if it is, it is not the main goal. But Allah wants it for us to be the main goal. وَابْتَغِي فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ ولا تنسى نصيبك من الدنيا. Don't do like the kafirs. The kafirs seek with all that Allah has given them, seek the pleasure of this life. Seek the pleasure of this life. And they don't have anything beyond that. Even those who call themselves Christians or Jews nowadays, and even if they have some goal, even if they want some share in the hereafter, they are not seeking the way to it. The only way for everyone is to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No room for any other one besides him. The following should be only for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just like the worship, the following should be for the Messenger of Allah, just like the worship should be for Allah. You see. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains to us then in some detail. He says, وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ. وَأَحْسِنْ, do good. Do good, do the best. But what is the best? A lot of people think they are doing the best. But if you look at their way, you don't find much. You find a mixture of things that they made up by their own, or someone has made it up for them. Unfortunately, sometimes you find everything but the right way being followed. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Bada al-Islam ghariba wa sayaud ghariba fa tuba lil-ghuraba." Islam has started straight. Few people who say la ilaha illallah and act upon it. Few people. And sayaud ghariba, it will come back again. The Prophet ﷺ said, it started like this and it will come back again to be strained. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَحْسِن وَأَحْسِن, be, do good. What is ihsan? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained وَأَحْسِن and إِحْسَان in his book clearly. He ordered us to obey Allah and his messenger, to respond to the call of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A lot of people think it's easy just to say I follow the Sunnah. They do a lot of things which have no basis in Sunnah. And they not only do it, but they do it with great enthusiasm, thinking that they are doing the right thing. Like the Khawarij, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma said, in the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes them, يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا. They think that what they are doing is the right thing. And the Khawarij came in a time the companions were there. And yet they secluded themselves from the companions. Imagine how Iblis could take you to that way. You have the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam with you. And they were living examples of Islam. Each one of them was a living example. And yet the Khawarij thought they are more knowledgeable than the companions. Once there was one of the Khawarij doing or standing with his fellow friends, and a companion رضي الله عنه was a very old companion at that time, was praying, holding his camel, praying and holding his camel. So they started gossiping, say, look, he wants the dunya, he is holding his camel, you see. Then the camel ran away and the companion was holding to it, his face to the Qibla, because he was praying and holding to the camel. So they called him, they said, come here, ayyuha al-shaykh al-dhal, you are the deviant shaykh, come here. The companion of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with them, and that's how they look at them. Unfortunately, everyone who looks at the true scholars in his time, in a degrading matter, in a belittling way. He thinks that he is above them. He knows, and they don't know. He acts upon whatever he thinks is the truth, and they don't act. You see? So they are still here amongst us, those Khawarij. They are amongst us. As the Prophet ﷺ said about Khawarij, they will be coming out a generation after generation. And they will not be terminated until the time Dajjal comes out. And a lot of them will be following the Dajjal. So my dear brothers, Allah made it very clear that your goal is the hereafter. And that have your share of this dunya. Have your share in the halal way as we explained. وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ. Do all that which is good. Learn the true faith. Learn how to establish the salat. Establishing the salat is different than just praying. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ حَافِظُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ. This is not just saying صَلُّوا. No. إِقَامَةَ means to make it straight. Your salat has to be according to sunnah. As the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِي أُصَلِّي. You can find the description of the salat in the books of fiqh. All the madhabs, Hanafi, Hanbali, Maliki, Shafi'i. And if you are following one of those madhabs, alhamdulillah, it's better than being your own mufti. You see, a lot of people, especially the youth, they want to act different from everyone. When you ask them, they say, we are following the sunnah. We are following the sunnah. And what was Abu Hanifa following? What was Shafi'i following? What was Malik following? What was Imam Ahmad following? The sunnah. Nothing but the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this poor guy thinks that the way he is understanding the sunnah, this is following the sunnah. The sunnah has to be followed both by knowing the words of it and knowing the authenticity of it. This is one thing. And then the second, which is more important, to know the meaning of the sunnah. To know the meaning by following the scholars. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who listen and follow the best. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. يا رب بسم الله. الحمد لله وأصلي وأسلم على عبده ونبيه محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله. When Allah ordered us to do good وأحسن كما أحسن الله إليك, He chose one of those good things from all other things, he chose this. He said, وَلَا تَكُوْ وَلَا تَكُوْ مِنَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. Don't be amongst those who do innovations and corruption. Don't be amongst those. Don't be with them. And this fact we remind ourselves in Fatiha every rak'ah when we say غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Okay. That means one of the good things that Allah has ordered us is to stay away from someone who carries deviation with him, and not to listen to him, and not to be with them. And this is very important in Islam. Some books of Aqidah which were written more than 1,200 years ago, they start a book with this title. That is, to be away from the innovators. And for the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ آوَى مُحْدِثًا. The curse of Allah be upon someone who sits with an innovator. The curse of Allah. Because even simply sitting could lead to arguments with him. And Allah forbade us from arguing the innovator. Also, don't argue with the non-Muslim, except when you yourself can affect him. You have a strong knowledge of Islam and you know how to speak in the right way and you know how to be wise in da'wah. What to start with, what not to start, what to make before the other, and so on. And this fact of staying away and not being with the deviants, whoever they are, whether they are kafirs, whether they are innovators, you have to stay away from them because there is no time for you on this earth. You don't have that much time to argue. So if someone wants to argue and you feel that he is not even listening to you by his heart, he is only listening to you by this piece of meat, that's all. His heart is away from you. In his heart he would be thinking, oh, how would I overcome and how do I prove myself right? And how do I prove him wrong? And things like that. Therefore, if you find someone who argues and who doesn't want to follow the truth, it will be not only haram to speak to him and argue with him, but it is one of the big sins in Islam. And we remind ourselves in every rak'ah of our prayer, إِيَّاكَ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. Not the path of those who went astray, and the path of those who Allah have become angry upon. So we have to keep this in mind. You cannot be doing ihsan, doing goodness, except by doing this particular goodness or good action, and that is to stay away. Don't argue with the kafirs and mushriks. If you want to give them da'wah, if you feel you are strong and he's not arguing, he probably needs to be, he needs someone to explain to him the truth. And you feel that the man wants the truth, so go ahead and give him da'wah. Da'wah is another great thing to do in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. This is the faith, the true faith. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. Da'wa is تَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen and follow the best. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا وعافنا. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر المسلمين حيثما كانوا. اللهم لا تحرمنا من فضلك الواسع ورحمتك. اللهم أغثنا اللهم أغثنا اللهم أغثنا. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أقم الصلاة.